What's good with y'all, man? Hey, you know what's so fucking crazy to me? The only time the motherfuckers give Giannis credit and mention Giannis as far as being elite and the best player in the game is when they compare him to LeBron. Have you ever noticed that? So niggas been shitting on Giannis, you know what I'm saying, for the longest, right? Not giving him his credit. You know why? Because he don't idolize LeBron. Like, you feel me? He got a Mamba-type mentality. So they like, well, wait a minute, hold on. But then he got a skill set of a LeBron where he can do everything good. Like, you know what I'm saying? And then his size, his strength, his quickness, you feel me? His similarities in the open court, you know what I'm saying? Getting the ball and watch out. You can't stop him coming down the lane. You know what I'm saying? You're not going to get in his way. When you have a player of that magnitude, you know what I'm saying, with that much force and size and ability and speed and strength, you know what I'm saying, coming at you full throttle in the open court, right? But they compare him. That's the only time they're going to give Giannis his just due is when LeBron is mentioned alongside of his name. Like, you know what I'm saying? And it's, you know what? That's a fair comparison. Giannis has plays just like LeBron. Giannis does. He plays just like LeBron, but he has a Kobe Bryant mentality. So think about that. And the reason why we shit on LeBron, you know what I'm saying? Not because he's not a talented basketball player. He's a great athlete because of the mentality. You know what I'm saying? Because of the crybaby-like antics. You know what I'm saying? Because of the willingness not to really get better and expand your game, but to pretty much play the same way from when you came into the league to now, to not exhausting all the possibilities, you know what I'm saying, to be the best player that you can possibly be in the world. You get what I'm saying? So shying away from, you know what I'm saying, the moment, you know what I'm saying, not having a killer mentality, not, you know what I'm saying, I will do anything at all costs to win. You feel me? And I'm not talking about PEDs and motherfucking stacking a deck. You know what I'm saying? Are you willing to bring your teammates along with you? Are you willing, you know what I'm saying, to dive into a greater you? You know what I'm saying? And that's the knock that we give on a guy. His bitch-like mentality and attitude and prima donna type characteristics that he display, we don't like that because we seen what it looks like for a motherfucker to get something out of the mud who didn't have nothing, and all he did was want to win and be the greatest at his profession that he can possibly be while helping others along the same path, and you know what I'm saying, in their journey. You get what I'm saying? And that's why so many players idolize Kobe, you know what I'm saying, on a deeper level than they do LeBron. But it's good for business when they mention LeBron in a positive light. You get what I'm saying? So it's good for the game. It's good for media coverage. It's good for press. You feel what I'm saying? When you say LeBron this, LeBron this, LeBron this, LeBron this. Like, you get what I'm saying? So it's just funny how these niggas don't want to. And then fat ass Brian Windhorst, we know he going to make a comparison to LeBron. You know what I'm saying? Because that's his guy. You feel what I'm saying? So, he should have went to the Met Gala. Brian Windhorst should have went to the Met Gala yesterday dressed as the Hamburglar. You know what I'm saying? Straight up, nigga. Stealing everybody double cheeseburgers, double quarter pounders, Big Macs, nigga. You feel me? So on and so forth. If he would have went to the Met Gala in a motherfucking, as the Hamburglar, nigga, he would have had the nigga hands down the best dressed outfit, nigga. But we had to look at motherfucking Adam Family Values looking motherfucking Russell Westbrook. Nigga, what the fuck are you wearing? Nigga, old Roddy Piper looking motherfucker. What the fuck you got a skirt on for, bro? That's not fashion, my nigga. You think that looks good, nigga? That is not. You got a son, bro. You got a family, nigga. You want your family and your children to grow up wearing skirts, nigga? Y'all might as well just say, fuck, what you need a wife for? You and D-Wade, nigga, what y'all need women for, bro? You might as well put a skirt on each other and makeup on each other. You know what I'm saying? And fuck with each other. It's the same shit. Nigga, let your woman raise your children. That's the problem right now. Niggas, these niggas is bitch made, and the motherfucking women, these niggas, they turn into the niggas. So, you might, yeah, nigga, it's a reverse psychology, nigga. Let the woman raise the children, and the man, nigga, you be the housewoman. How about that? You wear the skirts, the panties, the aprons, and so on and so forth, nigga, and have all your motherfucking the makeup kits and hair everywhere in the bathroom, nigga. Go get a weave. Go do the whole shit. Why don't you just change who God created you to be? How about that? Why don't you just alter your DNA? Why don't you do all that shit, nigga? Matter of fact, nigga, while you at it, why don't you go play in the WNBA, nigga? We'll take Brittany Griner, nigga. You feel me? We'll take that motherfucking broad. You know what I'm talking about? While she over there smoking, nigga, big ganja, nigga, in the Ukraine, nigga. So I don't even want to hear it, bro. Or in Russia, wherever the fuck she at, nigga. You feel me? So, y'all motherfuckers is crazy, bro. But this nigga Giannis look like Russell Westbrook. He looks, all of these niggas look like Wayman, nigga, from a Low Down Dirty Shame, bro. You feel me? Straight up. They look like Wayman. You know what I'm saying? You wasn't saying that last night. But that boy, that boy woke up, boy had a bad, that boy was about to kill that boy, cuz. This shit crazy, bro. All these motherfucking Wayman looking ass motherfuckers and shit and skirt and dress wearing motherfuckers. I don't understand what's going on, nigga. These niggas ain't created players, nigga. I don't know what one look like, nigga. You can go to, these niggas are NBA 2K created players, bro, where you can go and make them niggas look wild and crazy. If anybody play 2K online and you be seeing niggas' characters and they be having weird shit on, I'm like, nigga, you finna step on a hoop court, nigga? Like, nigga, in that? Like, nigga, just go put some shorts on, bro. An armband, a headband, like normal basketball accessories. Nobody wanna see niggas out there dressed, nigga, with all different type of shit on, nigga, face mask. It's like, these niggas is weird, bro. We're living in a new weird order. Not the new world order, the new weird order, nigga. It's still NWO, but it's just the new weird order. These niggas is fried, bro. These niggas' mind is fried, nigga. You know that game Minecraft? That's what's going on right now, nigga. In The Walking Dead, it's a whole bunch of Walking Dead, Resident Evil zombie-looking motherfuckers walking around these streets, nigga, with the brains of the motherfucking Ren 10 Tin Man from The Wizard of Oz, nigga. And I'm trying to tell you niggas, in the heart of the nigga, the Scarecrow. I was like, oh my goodness. These niggas, boy, this shit is fucking crazy. And we teaching our young kings and queens this. So the Hamburglar and the Adams Family values, like, you know what I'm saying? I don't understand what the fuck Russ is doing, bro. And that's the only reason Russ is gonna stay in the NBA, nigga, because of the agenda he's pushing. And he has a son, bro. He talks all that shit like he's hella hard to the fans and the motherfuckers on the basketball court and to the media personnel. But then when you go home, nigga, you play dress up and put on a skirt, bro, and panties, nigga. So how does that make you hard? And from what part of L.A. do they do that at? This ain't Frisco, nigga, where niggas in the Castro district, nigga, is, you know what I'm saying? Oh, I'm talking about all the way out of the closet, nigga. I'm talking about, nigga, they done took their closet, nigga, and put it on every corner. Nigga, that's the type of closet I'm talking about, nigga. Where your closet, you can actually go into the closet, nigga, and go shop. You feel me? So, then that's the Castro district in the city. In the Bay, out here in the Bay, man. You feel me? My mother didn't know about the Castro. Niggas know about that Castro, bro. You know, on some real other shit, bro. I'm like, y'all niggas, keep me away from the warp zone, bro. I don't go nowhere near that motherfucker, nigga. I'm going to stay on this side of the bridge. Unless I'm going to eat at a restaurant, all the good food, you know what I'm saying? Spots is over on that side and the pier, you know what I'm talking about? And nice beaches and shit. Other than that, nigga, keep the big parks and shit, nigga. Keep me away from all that other shit, bro. But I didn't know they get out like that in L.A., nigga. They didn't turn motherfucking Hollywood, nigga, into the Castro, nigga, 20.0, nigga, straight up. I don't know what's going on, but these niggas is on some rituals. These niggas in these rituals, niggas, to accumulate some success and all of this shit. That shit is crazy, nigga. And I wouldn't be surprised, nigga, if they did the same thing. I wouldn't be surprised if Giannis did that shit, bro. On one of them rituals type. On one of them ritual type missions. They went all the way across the nigga, across the world, nigga, to go grab this particular motherfucker. They said, oh, we can make him the next star. This particular motherfucker. They was like, we can make him the next LeBron. See, it was all a transition. You know what I'm saying? That's why Kawhi didn't stay in the East. Kawhi could have dominated the Eastern Conference. You know what I'm saying? For years. That Toronto team, if they would have kept that team intact, nigga, and just get younger and get bigs and shit, nigga, because Marcus Gasol was on his way out, they could have kept that roster intact. But that was all just, you know what I'm saying, for to get Toronto and Drake. Drake? The nigga that hired the kids from his wife and the wife and the kids? That was all a motherfucking orchestrated to get Drake and that nation and that country a world championship. You know what I'm saying? They didn't put their motherfucking time in. It was about time for them to get one ring because, you know these one and done rings that they give niggas. And that's how you know that these motherfuckers really don't be that good, but they just get a one and done. You know what I'm saying? A one and done ring. Come on, bro. Boston. Even though Boston had, you know, hella rings, but that under Doc Rivers, nigga, that was a one and done with that with the type of team that they had, and they only won one. Come on, bro, stop it. Toronto, that type of team that they had, and they only won one, and we know that why they won that one, nigga. No KD, Clay get injured, no excuses, but that's what happened. Let's keep it 100, nigga. That's what happened. They lost. They still lost straight up, but injuries played a factor. You know what I'm saying? You can say that with the 2015 Warriors. Kyrie, Kevin Love get injured. Even though Kevin Love got injured like in the first round against Boston or whatever, he been had got injured. So he was done for the whole playoffs. But if they would have had a Kyrie, you know what I'm saying? Who knows? Maybe that game, maybe that series don't turn out the way it do. Or maybe it still turns out the way it does. You know what I'm saying? Maybe just the Warriors' time and it was just that great. Because we've seen that the Warriors won two more after that, and they went to five straight. So it wasn't no fluke. They were really that good, and they're, you know what I'm saying, pushing to go to another one this year. So we'll see how that turns out with no size in your front court, but we'll see how that turns out. You know what I'm saying? So this is what it is, bro. You know what I'm saying? These niggas be selling their souls, nigga, for fame. It's crazy how ironic that now they're comparing Giannis to LeBron. So Giannis has LeBron's skill set with a Kobe Bryant mentality. Good luck stopping that. But in my opinion, I still don't think Giannis is the best player in the NBA. Is he dominant? Yeah, Joel Embiid is dominant. The Joker, in my opinion, is dominant. In my opinion, he doesn't do it with force. He does it with a little bit more skill, you know what I'm saying, and finesse. But I think the Joker is dominant. Motherfucking, I like Jason Tatum, bro. At his size and being able to do everything, I don't think there's any limitations on Jason Tatum's game, especially if he commits to the defensive end of the floor. You know what I'm saying? Now, as far as the mentality, you know he idolized Kobe Bryant. So him having that mentality of I want to be the best and then going out and giving you straight buckets and going at you, you know what I'm saying? I give him the edge over Giannis because of the ability to create shots for himself, period. If Giannis had a game where he can get to a spot and pull up for a jump shot, you know what I'm saying? Then, yeah, I'll give it to Giannis. But Giannis, he's a great defender. Yeah, Giannis is a great defender. He gives maximum effort on that side of the ball. He's long, right? And then he's dominant once he gets into the paint. He's able to, you know what I'm saying, one step from the three-point line at the rim. He's either dunking it on you or laying the ball up with his footwork and his Euro steps. You get what I'm saying? But if you take that away from him, like Boston did in that first game, if you take that away from him, it limits what he can give you. So now he has to be great in all the other areas of the game. See, like, you see what I'm saying? Like, if you take something away from, like, a Jason Tatum, he has something else in his back pocket. And then if you take that away, he got something else in his back pocket. Jason Tatum can post. He got a mid-range game. And he can expand it to the three. And he can drive to the rack, either dunk on you or hit you with layups. You feel what I'm saying? Giannis is either going to drive, dunk on you, hit you with layups, and that's it. On the offensive side of the ball. He doesn't have the greatest handle. He doesn't have the greatest handle with his size, his strength, and his quickness. At that, you know what I'm saying, at that height, he's able to create space. Like, you get what I'm saying? And get to that rim. But if it comes down to him making that play and pulling up for jumpers for game, see, if the defense take away your strength, bro, you got to be able to have a backup to the backup. Like, you get what I'm saying? You got to have a backup and then another backup to the backup. And I don't think Giannis is that great yet to where he has mastered the pull-up jump shot and the post-up game, in my opinion. Being able to turn left shoulder, right shoulder, and get a bucket. You know what I'm saying? Or hit you with like a little, you know, post fadeaway. We've seen him display that shot. But again, he's not comfortable with shooting that shot. So as Giannis's career, you know what I'm saying, expands as the years go on and on and on, and he starts to get older, that's really going to separate his game and really tell the story. See, it's easy to say a motherfucker is great, he's dominant, he's the best in the world, you know what I'm saying, when they're young and they still have their quickness, athleticism, their strength, and all these other attributes, right? But can the game slow down to you to where you can dominate the game, you know what I'm saying, doing something that's secondary or third, you feel me, to, you know what I'm saying, your primary? And I don't think Giannis is at that stage yet. And I think that Jason Tatum has developed his game, you know what I'm saying, to the point to where he can, you know, score on all different levels, on all three tiers. You know what I'm saying? That's just my opinion. You know what I'm saying? That's just how I see it. And I break it down like that. Like, is Giannis a skilled player? Is he dominant? Yes. Can he sustain and get better? I don't think he can sustain it as if he doesn't get better in other areas. He can't sustain his level of dominance if he does not get better in other areas. And only time will tell. And we'll see how many championships that he end up with in regular season MVPs. You know what I'm saying? In finals MVPs, etc. Even though regular season MVPs really don't mean nothing. But if you're going to go with somebody being the best in the world, now all the other, you know, accolades have to follow that best in the world, you know, title. So, that's what it is, bro. I know I started off talking about motherfucking Russ and fat ass the Hamburglar, Brian Windhorst, but, you know, I like to kind of dive deep and then, you know, I'm all over the place, but you know what? I wouldn't be me if I wasn't. So, salute to all my Knicks. I appreciate all y'all. Salute to all the queens out there and the goddesses, baby. You feel me? Doing your thing. Keep pushing through all the adversity, man. You know what I'm saying? Because adversity build character. You know what I'm saying? Adversity also separate the real ones from the fake ones, man. You know what I'm talking about? So, you know, make sure you like, share, subscribe. Fuck with your boy one time, even though they try to hold a nigga down. I ain't going nowhere because we can't be stopped now. Real easy for life. I ain't going nowhere because I can't be stopped now. It's real easy for life. You feel me? That's what it is, man. Holla at your boy, and I'm talking about.